But children are our messengers into the future. They're our immortality machines. They're our existential projects.
So I'm asking you, what do you want to have both ceremonies, and so what do you want to do? You want to have a confirmation, you want to have a Holy Communion, you want to have a bar mitzvah, you want to have, what do you want to do? Have every single ceremony that there is? You want to have them believe in the Old Testament and the New Testament? I mean, what are they gonna believe in? You got to think about them.
We want to be able to identify with our children. We want them to be like us.
When a couple is courting and when they're preparing for marriage, nothing should be left unanswered.
What was important was that there not be an odd person out, that we represent both heritages.
The difficulty that a lot of parents face in dealing with the issue of how to raise children is that there's a lot of fear addressing the question, because it goes to the heart of their own attitudes toward each other's heritage.
Whether you bring a child up with one religion or with two, it's a complex affair. It's filled with paradox, filled with uneven lines. There really is a lot of gray, let's say.
Now, when it comes to interfaith families, obviously you have the added complication of the duality, that there are questions of who shall prevail. What do we really want?
I'm Jewish.
You're Jewish?
Mm-hmm. Are you?
I am, as a matter of fact.
Is him? Is him? Is she?
I have two religions, but Mommy and Daddy have one. And Mommy has Jesus, and Daddy has Jewish.